Hello friends. As technology advances, so do our options on travel. Not only do our options for how we travel change, but so do the options for where we travel. Will space tourism ever be a reality for the rest of us? Elon Musk, the CEO of SpaceX, recently announced that two unnamed people will be flying in a loop around the moon on a holiday trip that they have paid significant amounts of money for. Space tourism is an exciting and innovative area, but a lot of debate surrounds it. Apart from the obvious technical difficulties that crewed flights to space present, there are also questions surrounding affordability, morality and potential environmental concerns that may set back the potential new industry of space tourism. Companies such as Richard Branson's Virgin Group are betting big bucks that the answer is yes. In fact, for a mere $20,000 deposit on a $200,000 ticket, you can go ahead and reserve a seat aboard Branson's Virgin Galactic Spaceship 2, slated to become the first commercial spacecraft when it launches in the next few years. Each flight will take 6 passengers on a 2.5-hour jaunt into suborbital space, that's 68 miles above the surface of the Earth. Once there, passengers will get to float free from their seats and gaze out at a view that Virgin Galactic CEO George Whitesides describes as a transformative experience. Continents, oceans and storm systems will stretch silently below while the void of space spans overhead. If $200,000 still sounds like a hefty price tag, that's because outer space is an expensive destination, even if you don't plan to spend the night. NASA spends about $10,000 just to get a pound of payload into orbit. If you thought the flight was pricey, just consider the expense of hanging out in orbit. The International Space Station came with a price tag of somewhere between $35 billion and $100 billion. That includes material, supplies, engineering, communications and life support systems. Such are the costs of overcoming the planet's gravity and bedding down in an incredibly hostile environment. Still, companies such as Canada's Space Island Group and even Hilton Hotels have eyed the long-term goal of establishing orbital accommodations for tomorrow's space tourists. For that goal to become a reality, however, spaceflight technologies will have to both improve tremendously and become more economically feasible. In addition, there's the added health issue. Modern astronauts brave harrowing G-forces, the risk of radiation exposure and guaranteed bone mass loss. As space tourism becomes increasingly real, government agencies will undoubtedly take an increased interest in passenger safety. Some experts estimate tourist space flights as becoming mainstream as soon as the 2020s, so if you're desperate to take a flight beyond Earth's gravity, don't give up hope just yet. Thanks for watching. And if you like this video, subscribe my channel and turn on the notification bell. Give a thumbs up, comment and share.